evening and welcome to a very special comedy edition of Masterclass. And we're very lucky to have with us in the studio this evening the actor Hugh, fresh from his triumphant appearance in my production of A Midsummer Night's Dream at Stratford, where he played the part of Bottom. Hello, Hugh.
Hi.
Hi. Hugh, you've proved that you're a master of dramatic comedy by the way you handled your Bottom in my dream. But tonight, we're going to be concentrating much more on audience skills.
Right.
All right? So you've done your exercises, you're fit and you're ready to go.
I think so.
Okay, on your feet then.
Well, I am on my feet.
No, this is comedy, Hugh. Always on the balls of your feet for comedy. Always on the balls for comedy. Okay. That's very important. Good. All right. Now, because we're going to be doing some joke work, some gag work, I'm going to give you a simple joke, and I want you to deliver it. All right?
Okay.
All right?
I won't say it was a small town, but the speed limit signs were back to back.
Good. Relax. Off your balls. Okay. Hugh, I wonder if you knew this. In all comedy, there are only two jokes. Did you know that? Just two jokes.
That wasn't one of them, was it?
No. It was both of them, Hugh. All right? Because the two jokes are, firstly, a blurring and a slipping of moral categories, and secondly, logic gone awry. That's what they were laughing at. All right? So bear that in mind and try again.
Can I try it with another joke?
What's wrong with this one, Hugh?
Well, I don't think it's very funny.
You mean you don't think it blurs the moral categories enough? I think it blurs them plenty, Hugh. On your balls, okay. Have a go.
I won't say it was a small...
I don't want to stop you here, Hugh.
Oh, all right.
No, I won't say I it was a small... I don't want to stop you, but I'm afraid I'm going to have to. Oh. All right, so relax and off your balls. Hugh, comedy.
Yeah.
Comedy, comedy, comedy. Comedy, Hugh, is about sharing, isn't it? It's about community. Com-a-dy. Community, if you like. All right? So, as an artist, you have to create an atmosphere of sharing with all those around you. All right? There's a simple technique to do that. It's called the beckon, and I'm going to show it to you. It breaks down the barrier between yourself, the artist, and the audience, the audience. All right? So, I'm going to go down and beckon. Beckon them into your world of comedy. All right? It's quite simple. Have a go. Well, that's an atmosphere of sharing and intimacy, isn't it? All right, but we also need an atmosphere of danger and excitement, don't we? And for that, there's a technique whereby you pretend that there are people standing, Hugh, in the wings or the sides of the stage, and they don't want you to go on, all right? They don't want you to tell your joke.
Because it's not very funny.
For whatever reason, Hugh, for whatever reason. Right. So what happens is, as you come up on your balls to beckon, you take a look left and right to check they're not there. It's called a take, all right? So you go... Right. And did you notice my tongue came out a couple of times? That's called tonguing the gag in. That's also important. It helps create the sharing. You know? Well, reasons, Hugh, reasons. All right, okay. So put it all together on your balls. Have a go.
Right.
I won't say it was a small town, but the speed limits were back to back.
Good, good, well done, well done. There's one slight textual problem there, Hugh. Oh, yeah. It's the speed limit signs are back-to-back.
Oh, sorry.
All right? You just said the speed limits were back-to-back. It's quite important. That. Imagine how small the town would be if its speed limit signs were back-to-back. How small would that be?
Quite small.
Very small.
Yeah.
Yes? And that's the joke, you see. All right?
Well,
yes, carry on.
Well, I mean, why do I say that I'm not going to say it's a small town and then say it's a small town?
Never analyse comedy, you. Never. Don't try and break it into little pieces. It's beautiful, it's lovely as it is. Don't smash it up.
Right.
All right? Let's just say it's part of the internal craziness of the gag, all right?
Right.
And that brings me on to another technique, and that's laughing the joke in. You find it so crazy that you can't help laughing at it yourself, all right?
Okay.
So... I won't say it was a small town. But the speed limit signs were back to back. You see? You see? Don't worry about the northern accent, that'll come later, all right? Okay. So, Hugh, I've written down for you on a piece of paper one or two words I want you to add to your routine. They all help create this atmosphere we've been talking about.
No, stop it, don't.
Yes, that's right. No, stop it, shh, don't, no, ah. You see? And I've given you a catchphrase there. That's your catchphrase.
Don't you start, madam.
That's it. Now, make it your own, Hugh.
Right.
Well, no, you're going to need to read it.
Oh, okay.
All right, so if you go off, I'll introduce you, put it all together, see what happens.
Yes.
Oh, Hugh, We could incorporate that comedy trip we did last week in the tumbling masterclass. Do you remember?
Yeah, okay.
We'll use that, see if it works. All right?
Right.
Off you go, then. Ladies and gentlemen, live on this stage making his comedy debut, please, a very warm hand for Hugh, Don't You Start, Madam Laurie. Yes! Shit! Carry on, take on the wings.
No, stop it, though. Don't you. Oh, listen, look. Aha, aha, yes. I won't say it was a small town.
Catchphrase.
What?
Catchphrase, Hugh.
Oh, sorry. Don't you start, madam.
It's not to me, to the audience.
Oh, don't you start, madam.
Good, good, good. And now tag.
But the speed limit signs were back to back.
That's wonderful. Well done, Hugh.